Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today, we are going to make a cityscape inspired by famous American pop artist, James Rizzi. To do this project, you're gonna need a piece of paper, something to draw and write with, and crayons, paint, or markers for coloring. Let's get started. To make our cityscape, we're going to start with some basic lines and shapes. I'm gonna start in the middle of my paper, and I'm gonna start with a rectangle. So I draw a rectangle by just making a straight line up, a line over, and make another straight line down. This is going to be the first building in my cityscape. From this building, I'm going to add some more lines. I think I'm gonna do a line that looks like stairs coming up on this side. Straight line over and up, over and up, over and up, over, and then I'll bring my line straight back down. Let's come to the other side. I'm going to start at the end of one, the other side of the rectangle. I'm going to make a straight line up, and this time I think I'm going to make a flattened rainbow shape. It comes over, and a straight line that comes back down. You're starting to be able to see my buildings formed, and you can do any kinds of lines that you would like, or any types of shapes that you want to add to it. So maybe on this side, I'll make a straight line over, so I have another rectangle, but I'm going to add a triangle on top. I'm gonna come to this side and maybe I'll make a slanted line up. So I start near the top of that building, that last building I drew, and make a straight line sliding up. So now I have some basic buildings. You can make as many buildings as you want because when we're drawing art, you really wanna fill up the whole paper. You don't wanna have any empty spaces or a tiny little picture inside. You wanna make your lines big or your picture big so that your entire paper is filled. Next, I wanna add some fun faces. If you can find any of James Rizzi's art, you will see that he always included some fun character faces on all of his buildings. So I'm gonna do that now. And again, I'm just going to be using basic lines and shapes to make these. So I'm gonna start on the left. And I think I'm gonna start by making thin rainbow shapes. I'm gonna close them with a flattened smile line. I'm gonna draw some circles inside. And right above them, I'm going to do another flattened rainbow line. Then maybe I fill in the eyes a little bit and leave that little shine by leaving a little white in it. Next, I'm going to add maybe a triangle nose. And I'm gonna give a nice big smile. And I'm gonna draw what kind of look like squares for some teeth. All right, so I'm pretty happy with that face. So I'm gonna move on to my next building and draw a different shape. And again, there's no wrong way to do this. This is art, so you're gonna be as creative as you'd like to be. So feel free to make any kind of faces that you would like, or if you're having a little trouble coming up with your own, you can copy some of the ones that I do here. Let's do another face. This time I think I'm going to start with some sideways triangles. And they have a little bit of a rounded shape to them. Kind of looks like a bow tie. Right in the middle, I'm gonna come down, curve out, and around for a nose. I'm gonna go back inside those triangles and I'm gonna add some circles for eyes, and I'll just do a few more lines inside to make those eyes, and he needs a mouth too. So I'm gonna make a line. I'm going to make a thin smile line, so it looks like his tongue is hanging out. I'll add a line right inside. And then I'm gonna make a line that curves down, disappears behind the tongue, and curves back up. And I'll add some circles on the ends for cheeks. So that looks good. Let's move on to my next face. I think I'm going to just start with some basic ovals. So some long ovals here. I'm gonna make some circles inside. This one I think I'll add some eyelashes, so just straight lines on top. You notice I'm doing just a lot of lines and shapes. I'm gonna make a little curved nose. Another smile face, and I'm going to do short rainbow line right next to each other, and then a smile line on the bottom. So those look like lips now. And this time I'll add little wavy lines on the end. And I think I'm even gonna go back and add in a few lines inside that oval to complete my face. We've got two more. Let's get a little creative, a little different here. This time I think I'm going to do two flattened rainbow lines. And on the bottom, you're gonna do two flattened smile lines so that I have two football shapes. Inside, I'm going to make some circles. Inside those circles, I'm gonna do a zigzag line above it. So I leave a little space and do a little zigzag line above each eye. I'm gonna come right in the middle, make a V, and then close it. And at the bottom of the triangle now, I'm gonna make a curved line up. Another curved line up in the other direction. I add some straight lines, and now I kind of have a little cat face. And I've got one more building to decorate. Again, you want to do as all the buildings that you made. If you made more buildings than I did, feel free to do some more faces. Any kind of face that you want is wonderful. So I think I will finish up by doing another two thin rainbow lines. I'm gonna close them with flattened lines, flattened smile lines. Gonna make some straight lines on top. I think I'll do some eyebrows on this too, so I'm gonna make two little flattened rainbow lines. I'm gonna make some curves inside, look like parts of circles. I think I'll do a flattened oval nose and another little smile line, and I'll do some circles for cheeks. I'm gonna go back in and add some lines inside the eyes as well. All right, so now I'm really happy with all the faces that I've made. So next I'm gonna add in some windows. Again, I'm gonna be making shapes to make the windows. So I just come to the bottom of the buildings, and maybe I do some squares at the bottom, and then I just do lines to divide them. So I have some very simple windows. Maybe on this one, I'll come up top, I think I have some room, and I'll make a long rectangle and a wavy line across for that window. I'm also gonna put a window up top in this building. So I make a circle another cut it in half and cut it in half with another line. Maybe I'll make some more windows over here. I think I'll do another rectangle one. This time I'll cross it. This one I'll do some longer windows. Again, I'm just using shapes. So I have some rectangles here. I cut them in half with lines. And then I'll just make a few lines and go in the other direction, right across the middle. You can see that our buildings are really starting to take shape. Let me add some more windows here. In fact, I'm going to add another long window up top here. And then maybe some different windows down here. I think I want to give this window a rounded top. So I do a rainbow line. And then just add in those little details. Again, there's really no wrong way to do this. You can add any types of details that you want. And as long as you're having fun and you're happy, your art will show how happy you are and show your creative ability. I think everyone is an artist. You just have to practice and use your imagination. Alright, so now I'm pretty happy with my buildings, but I told you I always like to fill up my paper, so I'm going to go to the top and add in a few details as too. I'm going to add some clouds maybe, so I'll start with kind of a C, and I just continue that line around with some smile shapes or smile lines. It becomes a backwards C, and then short rainbow lines at the top, and you close your cloud. So I'm going to make a couple of those. And I use the same method that I just used before. Maybe I'll add a few hearts in. So I'm going to come over to this empty space and add some hearts floating up here in the sky. I think maybe I'll even add a bird, maybe sitting on top here. So to make my bird, I'm going to start with a V, close it with a rainbow line. I come down to the side of the V and make a oval that curves around. Some little lines inside there and on the side. Lines down with upside down V's and little dots for eyes. I just add up a couple more lines. I've got my little bird here. Maybe even on the building, I'll come down here because I don't want to leave this empty either. Maybe I'll even make a little balloon. So I make a circle or part of a circle. Then I make two little lines coming out, close it at the bottom and do a wavy line. I want to finish up the sky though, so I think I'm going to make a sun over here too. So I come to the end, and I'm just going to make a line that curves up. You could just make a circle with lines all around it. Again, it's really up to you. But you do want to fill up your whole paper, because artists always fill in everything. I think I'll add a few stars as well. Again, all you need are some different lines, different shapes, to really make your art come to life. All right, I've got a couple little empty spaces, so I think I'm gonna add some more hearts as well. And maybe another star as well. The top of my paper is looking really good. I really want to finish up the bottom though. I feel like I have a lot of empty space here. And like I said, I always like to fill in my entire space. So I think I'll just make maybe some cars. So I'm gonna make a nice big rainbow line. From the rainbow line, I'm gonna make some lines that come out and then come down. And I'm gonna stop for a second. I'm gonna come in the middle and make some circles. And then I'm gonna draw a straight line that disappears behind the circles. And I just made a little car here, and I can add in some windows on my car as well. You can make different types of cars. Maybe I'll make a rectangle one. Actually, I think this one is gonna end up looking more like a truck. Start with a rectangle. I'll do a square on the side. Add in some circles. So I've got my truck. And again, I think I wanna add some more balloons. Like I said, I really like to fill up my paper. Like to leave any empty spaces behind. And you know what? I'm actually gonna finish up with just some little wavy lines and doodles. So to do that, I call them kind of roller coaster lines. I start at one end and I just curve around and around and around. And I make it going across the building or going up top. Again, all these fun little details really bring your pictures to life. I think I'm just gonna finish up with a few more hearts. Or if some of these shapes are too complicated, you can make circles and call them little bubbles. I make a circle and add a little shine in it. Looks just like a little bubble floating up. All right. So now I've finished my picture. It has a lot of detail and it really embodies James Rizzi's art. You can see the faces like he used to do, and he added in a lot of shapes. So now we want to add some coloring and use a lot of vibrant coloring just like he did. So to do the coloring, I'm actually going to fast forward. If you want to pause the video, you can pause it and match the colors, or you can just pick some vibrant colors of your own. So we're gonna do that now. Now I'm all finished coloring. As you can see, I finished my landscape. I've got my city. I've got lots of bright colors all over the place. And I actually did two. I did one with marker and I made another one with crayon. You can color with whatever you like and whatever you feel most comfortable with, or whatever you just feel like using around the house. Crayons, markers, watercolor, paint, anything that you have is great. I hope you enjoyed this lesson and learned a lot about lines and shapes. And also, I hope this inspired you to learn more about artist James Rizzi. I'll see you next time on my channel. Bye. Yay!